BEEX Project is a no-profit foundation about visual art and photography. If you want to help us, just drop a donation on buymeacoffee.com/BerlinExplorer. So, welcome to this 50 minutes of experience. Today I'm with Eleonora Di Folco. Welcome, Eleonora.
Hi everyone. Thank you, Emiliano, for this opportunity because it's like the first time that I'm speaking in a podcast. So,
yes,
I'm,
so we will
I'm
do
a little bit
also
embarrassed.
More. We will do some more podcasts together. Then we'll have more different time to improve different way to talk.
Okay, I'm going to be honored. Thank you.
So before to just go to deep in your picture, I would love you to do it a bit of introduction of yourself, as you know, and then we can go a bit more deep. Yeah.
Okay, of course. So hi, everyone. My name is Eleonora and my heart name is Nora Diff. That's because when I was 1 year studying abroad, everyone can't pronounce my name in the correct way. So I started to feel more like Nora and not Eleonora. And then who I am? I am a young girl. I'm 23 years old and I really, really, really love photography. And actually I'm graduating in media art. So I'm like a photographer and a video maker and I do some installations. So it's like I'm into a full world of visual arts. So for me, it's not important if I can express myself in a photograph or in a video, but in the media. So if I have an idea, I will discuss with myself and try the best media to, you know, to say something and communicate with people.
Yeah, I totally understand. I mean, it's funny because I'm like that.
Okay, perfect.
So I'm not, I cannot focus as myself as only a photographer. And in the past was so difficult for me to, because yeah, everyone was always saying to me, yeah, but you have to do it one thing, because if you don't do it just one
yes,
thing.
Yes.
You know, all that bullshit people say to you. But yeah, in the end, I always throws about, okay, you can drive the car, you can eat, you can talk with people, you can write, you can do it a lot of things, you know, as a human, why I cannot be professionally something like that. And during the years, yeah, for sure, I develop a lot of myself as an artist, totally in 360 degree, and that provided me the capacities and the experience, and also the tools to be able to touch all of this topic different.
And, as human, we are like multitasking, no? So it's really difficult for me to be completely focused on one thing. So for me, it's impossible. So that's why I understand.
Yeah, it's more difficult for me to focus on one thing than 100 things. So when I'm always totally busy in a different field, I'm much more creative than when I have to do one thing. And I remember one day I was in a graphic design studio working and I had to do a really stupid task for all the month, and yeah, the first hour I have done this task, and I said, okay, now what the fuck I have to do?
yes.
You know, and I was there, and they was complaining that they didn't know what I was doing because I was going out often to smoke a cigarette. Yeah, but I completed the task in 1 hour, and they didn't know what to do. And for me, it was okay. I don't want to work anymore here. Also, if you pay me, I don't know, 100,000 euro, I don't want to come. Please don't let me come here.
Okay. Yes. I'm like you in this kind of, you know.
Yeah, and I always search the border. This is, I think, also you do it, no? It's always searching the border, the limit that you have to surplus this limit to find yourself.
Yes. Because, for example, I started to photograph because my father was a photographer. So when I was 6 years old, I was stealing his camera. So he was shooting with analog supplies. So you know, my father was really happy about that because he can, how to say, he saw that I was really happy taking pictures, no?
Yeah.
But at the beginning, I was stealing from him, so he doesn't know that I was stealing the camera. So when he was developing the films, he found some different photos. He don't remember about the photos because they were mine. And so I started really, really, really in a young way. So in this case, and I was photographing, you know, my life, my camera, my stuff. So it was like more a documentation.
Yeah, I like the way I like the way you also make the post on Instagram.
Oh, thank you.
I enjoy much more the story. I mean, also if you create a story more faster than what you can expect in a book that require more time. Mm-hmm. But for example, now I'm watching again this one of the posts is Puglia Tales, no?
Uh-huh.
And there is one old bari, two automaker cat of caccia happiness, so three wife and husband vacation, no? And I will say, it's really nice the composition, no? And then watching a story like that, and then there is also the bill and something I was a lot when I was more young. I was working a lot, not in Instagram, but I had the kind of diary like that. And
I wanted to like this kind of diary of my vacations, no?
Yeah.
So I was photographing my stuff, my friends. And then I also like graphic design, so that's why I'm trying to do like this different style in my Instagram to be more, I don't know.
Yeah, it's good. This is experiment yourself in a way, and that's
yes.
Also to make the profile more personal, I think, no?
Yes, it's also for that.
So what I would love to do with you, it's more about talking. In which way the photography in this case help you to connect with the world. And there are some pictures really interesting, like this analog fat of December 2020, okay. Where there are this light really particular fantasy scientific in a way, and this vision is more about is more clearly close to a movie of the 30 than something actual.
Okay, for example, in that photos I started photograph for I was a really introvert child, so for me it was really difficult to speaking with people, with some classmates, also because I was I'm cross-eyed, so when I was younger, without the glasses you can see that my eyes are not straight, so I was different, and everybody was looking at me like I was an alien and stuff like that. So for me, photographing things, it would be like some freedom, and I really enjoyed that. So it was a thing to connect people with my inner self. So that's why I started to do, for example, more abstract photographs. And the one that you previous talk about with the lights, it's actually because I was starting to work with light, and the light that is going like in diagonal in the photo is actually the sun. So I was doing like experiment with the long exposure, and because I really enjoyed long exposure, I discovered it in a lyceum high school because I was studying in an artistic field. But I was doing painting and sculpture. But then there was a professor that was really into photography, and he starting to explain me photography and long exposure and stuff like that. And then I just experiment with myself. I really find myself in the analog stuff. And also because when I was 1 year abroad, I studied in Poland for 1 year.
In Warsaw, yeah.
No, in Wrocław.
Okay.
And I really met some beautiful, beautiful, beautiful teacher, and his name was Stalin Shi. I hope I pronounce it well. And he was like the laboratory guy, and he was doing the all the analog stuff. And he really introduced me in the, you know, the process of developing and all the stuff. So I'm really grateful for him, because I now can develop and do all the stuff that I was experimenting with.
Yeah, it's
really
nice.
Yes.
And I'm really curious to know how is your process. In Do you usually taking picture, and then how much time pass between watching them, selecting them, publish them?
And okay.
It's more a process of capturing, or is a process of structuring?
No, it's more a process of structuring.
Yeah. Because,
for example, everything started from my mind. And then I have to process it. So I have to, you know, okay, for example, if I want to explain that feeling for me, what is that feeling? So I have a lot, I do a lot of research. I do a lot of, also in a philosophic or, you know, psychological way.
Yeah, yeah.
So I really like to go deep in this kind of feelings. And then I started to experiment. So, for example, I don't know, now I don't have a tangible example, but how to say, yes, I follow the path. So I do my research, I do my stuff, I read a lot, and then I keep all this stuff and put it together in this photograph.
And is there any way you're moved, influenced from what inspired you, we can say, no?
Yes, yes.
So in a way, yeah, like this influence ride your creativity in a way.
Yes, but for example, for the Puglia Tales that you mentioned before, it was more like a reportage documentary. So I was before capturing the images, and then I was like selecting them, trying to develop them. So that's why sometimes there are, how to say in English? There is like this this time that is going through, I mean, I take photos, and then there is a time, and then I will publish them, because I have to develop them. I mean, it's more a long process.
Okay, so downtime.
We can, yes, yes, okay.
The downtime between a process and another.
And, yes, and sometimes when I develop my photographs, I can see truly other stuff, for example. If I have some idea in my mind, then I develop my photo, I can see also some other things. It's like, you know, a full discover.
Yeah, 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 I totally got what you mean.
Okay, okay.
So, yeah. I did many kind of processing in my
life. Okay.
But in the end, I think I'm more for impulsive things. I mean, I like a lot to research, and this is something I do it as a curator, as an editor. I research a lot sometimes. Even I worked more than 1 year on just one project, so it's okay for me. But it's something I have to do for others, with the work of others. I cannot do it with my personal work in photography, because okay. I called totally burn everything I do it, because I start to hate totally.
okay, I understand.
And so it's I cannot. Yeah, in a way, it's like. I prefer much more to work with the work of other people, because you can dream a bit more, you can travel a bit more over them, feeling them, vision. And I wanted to know, are you based in Apulia, yeah?
What?
Are you based in Apulia, yeah?
No, I'm based in Frosinone near Rome.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, my holiday, yeah. My vacation.
Yeah, cool. And so you are originally from Rome, from Lazio?
Frosinone, yes.
Yeah, this is cool. Yeah, I was working there for some 10 years.
Really?
Okay. More than 10 years ago, probably.
Yes, because you are Italian too. Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, I'm Neapolitan. Yeah.
Okay.
So, yeah. And What I wanted to know, what do you think it's from your perspective, no? How is to be a creator in Frosinone?
Okay, it's a nice question because, you know, Frosinone is not a really big city. And, you know, for example, there are some people that are like, okay, so what are you doing? What are you studying? What are you... what do you want to say, no? And it's difficult here because, you know, if you are studying photography, you are going to do like the photo shoot for the marriage or the video for the marriage. So it's like a different way to see photography. So when I explain what I'm doing, what I'm trying to do, they're like, oh, okay, it's interesting, but maybe you have to go away. So a lot of people are talking to me like, okay, you really need to go away because here you don't have a lot of stuff. But it's not super true because recently I'm working with some other guys and girls that are trying to, you know, step away to this kind of situation because, for example, like in every city, there are a lot of young guys that want to improvise, to start doing things. For example, my ambition in life is to be DOP in cinema department. So in this period, I'm doing like shorts movie. I'm trying to express myself in a more cinematic way. And I'm really enjoying it because I also producing a video clip for a guy that is Antonio Tortorello, and I'm really pushing myself. So it's like it's my life. I'm discovering something new. So I'm gonna go away. No, go away. I'm going really deep in the stuff. So I'm trying to.
Yeah, but I'm sure there are many ways to refresh the vision of an artist in Italy. I mean,
yes. Move it out, because you know, Italy have a lot of history of art.
It's,
no?
it's the point is just what I think, and it's basically also in this project, no?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, first of all, I moved out not because I was not working, but I was working mm-hmm. not so too much in Italy. And
okay.
and the point is, in a way, I decided to also lose everything because, when you are based in Italy, you know, and you create your community, you create your client base.
Yes, yes, of course.
Obviously, when you go move, when you move out of the country, no one calls you anymore. So then you lose everything. And then it's really funny because when you go come back, also even, I don't know, after 1 year,
mm-hmm.
no one will call you anymore because it's kind of you are lost, no? But
yes, you are not in touch with all the.
Yeah, I mean, I'm moved out for other reasons. Most of the people ask me always, yeah, it's for the work, it's for the work. No, it's not for the work. It's because I cannot really deal with Italian because. I mean, it's not my. I mean,
I can. My, I can understand. I can understand.
It's my country, but it's not my country in a way. I feel more. I feel more a person of the world. I want to discover much more. I like to.
Yeah, me too.
Also, speak in different languages, and this is really important for me. That it's something I have to deal with every day. You know,
mm-hmm.
and. But I understand what you mean, and I would say also for sure there are thousands of different way of creating new kind of service, also not only in photography, in visual art.
Yes.
And, but it's the same here in Berlin. I mean,
probably here,
they will not ask you doing the photographer and then you do it only the wedding. They also understand other ways to doing the photography, also to doing the artist, the solo artist is okay. But even in the commercial part, for example, in my service, I introduced the documentary photography in the using of the business photography. So
okay.
It's something not everyone do it. And I'm just started to mix it up the different kind of tools. Do you hear this klaxon?
Yes, a little bit.
Yeah, this is welcome in Berlin. We have also here the Neapolitan people, the people from south.
Yes, of course. Yeah, I mean, Berlin is really big. I was there when I was in Poland because it was really near, no? It was like 4 hours with a bus. And I really enjoy the city because it's really big and you can meet a lot of different people. And for example, in my city, Frosinone, it's not like this.
It's a bit more close. I know. In summer, you can enjoy.
Yes.
I know exactly how it's there. I did, when I was working there, I was doing the manager of some DJs and we was organizing some party there.
Oh,
so
okay.
I know exactly how it's...
Okay, so nothing about photography?
Yeah, no, I'm about management and the artist, music, DJing, electronic music, that stuff.
Okay.
We can go on here for 20, 30 minutes more and also more. So the last question I want to ask you, and then, probably we can have also another podcast.
Okay.
I record for 2 hours or, you know. I wanted to know, this is exactly probably related to the Frosinone style, no?
Mm-hmm.
I will love to, you know, I do it sometimes challenges in the podcast. And more than a challenge here, it's probably an influence that I want to give you. And it's how do you think to reporting your city? I mean, telling many stories, I mean, stories in private, stories in public that describe your city from your point of view as a unique point of view because you are the owner of yourself and no one else can see the city like you. And describing the story in a picture, video, and what else you use for.
I mean, I actually did something like that. I mean, it's not in my public profiles because, you know, when you are a photographer...
The best work are always away from the public profile.
Yes, like always. Because, you know, when you are a photographer, you just have to be inspired also from your, you know, ambient. No, not ambient. How to say in English? Your
background.
Yes. So, for example, there were a period of myself when I was always with my camera and I was going in a, you know, famous spot of my city and I tried to capture these events. And then when I was looking at the photos, I mean, it's not something that I really feel mine. For example, I'm not more in a reportage or documentary anymore. I'm more into, you know, inner self and stuff like that, more philosophic way, oneric way. So was a period that I did it and I enjoyed because I discovered that I can express also this kind of, you know, stuff. For example, there is like, you know, places where I grow up. So I love to photograph that places because I had some photograph when I was younger. I photographed these places like when I was 10 or 12. And then when I was 20, I photographed them again. So you see the differences, no? When I was younger, it was more, you know, about feeling and also the height, no? I was smaller. So the point of view was different. And I really love to you know, work with time. So when I was younger and then when I grew up, so it was a really nice challenge. But it's not something that really correlates to me, if we can,
I don't know. I think just about will be nice to see how do you call the talk about Frosinone without talking about Frosinone.
Yes. This is.
I mean, in a way or another, you talk about Frosinone because of you are there, and also even if you create something else, you're talking about the place where you are. The place is there, is involved in your process.
Yes, yes, like the people you meet in your path, no?
Yeah.
For example, when I think the people are fundamental because they leave some kind of mark in your path.
Yeah, totally.
So
thank you a lot, Eleonora, for your time and your talk. And yeah, for sure, we continue in the next podcast.
Okay.
And
it's really nice that you want to talk more, because I have, for example, there is like a work that I made, some photograph that is with the pinhole. That is this kind of camera that.
Yeah, I have seen.
Yes, yes, yes. So it is going to be really, really nice if we can have a
podcast
again, so I can explain more that kind of stuff.
It's only a pleasure to talk with people who want to talk, want to communicate.
Yes, yes. I mean,
intention.
For being my first time, it was really, really nice.
Yeah, it was easy, no?
Yeah,
I try to do it like that. There are many people ask me, can I have the script before? I say, yeah, sorry, I cannot have the script because everything come to my mind all in the moment.
Yeah, it's like a discussion, no? We are taking a coffee together in a place.
Yeah, I'm already taking my coffee. I don't know.
Okay. I have my water here.
But yeah, it's like that. I like to take things with flow and to see what happened, you know. It's everything in
business. Yes, I prefer that. Yeah. The script is more like, you know, I don't know, I'm a little bit afraid about the script.
Yeah, so if anyone wants to see the work of Eleonora, it's really interesting and curiously, you can reach out there with the link in the description. You can also send a vocal message if you want, using the link in the end of the description, that you have just to sign up on anchor.com and just send over message, how many message you want, vocal message for 2 minutes, 3 minutes, or else. And I will add this vocal message in the next podcast. And thank you again for your time.
Thank you for your time.
And we will see in the second appointment together.
Okay, perfect. So I can schedule that.
Yeah. Thanks for listening to our podcast. Learn more about our project at allmylinks.com/BerlinExplorer, or visit our Instagram and follow Berlin Explorer Project.